Hi, welcome to the third chapter in manual testing, that is spiral model. This is the second model in SDLC. This video is brought to you from Ankpro training. Now let's see what are all the topics I'm going to cover in this video. That is, what is spiral model diagram, its phases and its procedure, requirement changes in spiral model, stages of requirements, advantages and drawbacks of spiral model, applications of spiral model and the possible interview questions. Now let's see what is spiral model. It is a step-by-step procedure to develop a new software. To overcome the drawbacks of waterfall model, we will go for spiral model. When we will go for spiral model, when there is a dependency between two modules, we can go for spiral model. See, here there is a module A and module B. We will go for spiral model when there is a dependencies between these two modules. Now let's see the spiral model diagram. This is the diagram of spiral model. Now let's see the phases of spiral model. In spiral model we have four phases. See, this is the requirement collection phase, this is the design phase, this is coding phase and this is testing phase. Now let's see the procedure of spiral model. Let's go back to the diagram. In this diagram there are three modules, that is A, B and C. For the module A, now let's see for module A. In module A, customer will give the requirement for module A in business language. BA will do requirement collection for module A. That is, BA will go to the customer place and collect the requirement in business language and he will convert it into a software language and he will explain to the developer, test engineers, etc. In the same requirement collection phase, feasibility study will be done. Then architect will do the design for module A and in this developer will do the coding for module A. And the test engineer will test the module A. While testing, if he find any difficulties or if he find any defect, he will communicate the defect to the developer. Developer will fix the defect and he will give the new software to the test engineer. Test engineer will uninstall old software and he will install new software. And he will test the defect first and he will continue the testing with module A. Once after testing is completed, he will release a module A to the customer. Then for module B, customer will give the requirement for module B, BA will do the requirement collection and in the same phase feasibility study will be done and architect will do the design for module B, that is he will do HLD and LLD and developer will do the coding for module B and test engineer will test the new module B and he will test the integration between A and B and he will also test the old module A. While testing, if you find any defect, he will communicate the defect to the developer. Developer will fix the defect and he will give the new software to the test engineer. Test engineer will uninstall old software, install new software and he will test the defect first. Once the defect is fixed, he will continue the testing with module B. Once after testing is completed, he will release the module A and module B to the customer. Then customer will give the requirement for module C. First, the same process will repeat for module C also, that is BA will do the requirement collection for module C and in the same phase feasibility study will be done and architect will do the design for module C, that is LLD and HLD and developer will be doing the coding for module C and test engineer will do testing as like first he will test the new module C and he will test the integration of new module with the old modules, that is he will test the integration between C, B and CA and he will test all the old modules, that is A and B. While testing, if he find any defect, he will communicate the defect to the developer. Developer will fix the defect and he will give the new software. Test engineer will uninstall old software and he will install new software and he will test the new module for defect. Once the defects are fixed, then he will continue the testing with new module C Once after testing is completed, he release module A, module B and module C to the customer. Now let's see how to do requirement changes in spiral model. First we see major changes. Whenever the customer requests for major changes in requirement in a particular model, then we change only the module and do test of both unit and integration of units. This change in requirement come up in a separate cycle just to do the changes. Now let's see how to do major changes. Let's assume customer will do the requirement changes in B module and it's a major change. In this case, we can handle major change as a part of one new cycle. For that, BA will do the requirement collection for major change in B module, and in the same phase feasibility study will be done, and architect will do design for major changes, and developer will do testing for major changes in module B. Test engineer will do testing, like test engineer will test the major changes in module B, and test engineer will test remaining portion of the module B, and he will test the integration between BA and BC, and he will test all the old modules. While testing, if there is no any defect, then test engineer will release module A, module B and module B with the major changes and module C to the customer. Let's see what are minor changes. Whenever the customer requests a minor changes in the product, then the software team makes the minor changes along with the new model to be developed simultaneously in a single cycle. Now let's see how minor changes will do. Let's assume customer want to do some minor changes in module B. Along with that, customer will give new requirement for module D. In this case, we will handle all the changes in as a part of one new cycle. Here BA will do the requirement collection for new module D and minor changes in module B. In the same phase, feasibility study will be done. Architect will be doing design for new module D, and he will do the design the minor changes in module B, and developer will do coding for new module D and some minor changes in B. Test engineer will test test new module B, and he will test the minor changes in B, and he will test the integration between new model and the existing model, and he will test all the old modules, that is A, B and C. Once after testing is completed, there is no defect, and he will release a module A, module B with minor changes, module C and module D for the customer. Now let's focus on stages of requirement. Requirement can be given in three stages. The first stage is CRS, that is customer requirement specification. The documents collected by business analyst during the requirement collection stage are known as CRS, and it is also called BRS, that is business requirement specification, and it's also called as BS, that is business specification. In this document, the client explains how their business works or the requirement of the software he need to develop. And the second one is SRS, software requirement specification. BA gathers CRS from the client and translate it into a SRS. The SRS contains how software should be developed and is given by the BA to the developer. And the third one is FS, that is functional specification. For more detailed explanation of how to go about developing the software, the BA or developer builds another document, that is FS. FS explains how each and every component should work. Now see the what are all the advantages of spiral model. In spiral model, requirement changes are allowed. And it is a control model, because after we develop one module of the product, then only we can go on to develop the next module of the product. So it is called control model. Investment done in a proper way. Testing is done in every cycle before going to next cycle, and customer can see the software for every module. Now let's see the drawbacks of spiral model. Testing starts only after coding in the spiral model, and it is a traditional model, and thus developers only did the testing job as well, and we cannot change the requirement in between the cycle. Every cycle look like a waterfall model. Requirement collection and design phases are not tested in the spiral model. Let's see the applications of spiral model. Whenever there is a dependency in building the different modules of a software, then we will go for spiral model. And whenever the customer gives the requirement in stages, in that case also we can go for spiral model. Let's see the possible interview questions on this topic, that is, what is spiral module? Explain spiral model diagram, its phases and its procedure. How to do requirement changes in spiral model? What are all the stages of requirement? What are the advantages and disadvantages of spiral model? For what kind of project we go for spiral model? Subscribe to our channel on YouTube, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, join our group on LinkedIn. Thank you.